Like Pauly Malignaggi is following in the footsteps of the WBC heavyweight champion Deontay Wilder in some of the crazy remarks he has stated that he wants to do against his upcoming opponent in a bare knuckle fight at the BKFC event taking place June 22nd in Tampa, Florida. Look, Pauly Malignaggi is a guy who runs his mouth. He's a guy who talks a lot of shit. We all know that early in his career, up until now, we've seen his press conferences with Amir Khan. We've seen his press conferences with Adrian Broner. We know that he's a guy with a slick mouth. He's from New York. He's an Italian. So we know those guys and women come with big attitudes and smart mouths. But he seems to be crossing the line like Wilder did. And I don't hear the outrage. Hell, he even went further than what Deontay Wilder did, in my opinion. He actually spit in the direction of our team Lowball. That is the ultimate no-no as a man towards another man. And bump just a man-on-man disrespect. That's as a human. You don't take the saliva from the pit of your stomach or the pit of your throat and launch it at somebody. That equals an automatic ass whooping. Hell, maybe even going past an ass whooping to killing your ass. We know, taught from a wee age, to never put your hands on somebody and to never spit on another person. That is grounds for a brutal, brutal ass beating. But Pauly Malignaggi don't give a fuck. He don't give a fuck. But the outrage should be just as high for him as it was for Deontay Wilder. Doesn't matter the status of him being a heavyweight champion in a bigger figure in the sport of boxing. Look, Pauly Malignaggi is a respected former fighter, two-time champion as a professional boxer. He is one of the better commentators for Showtime, one of the top networks in the sport of boxing. And he's a public figure. He's a public figure. People listen to his opinions. People follow him on social media, and they're catching wind of this. Not just grown-ups follow him on social media. Little kids follow him on social media, I'm pretty sure. And they seeing this, and they hearing what he's talking about, and they making the thing like, it's okay to spit on the mug. Because he disrespected my sport, I can spit on him, and I can wish bad on him. But it better be the same outcry, or it's a lot of hypocrites in this world. Malignaggi just seemingly off the rails. This guy Lowball is seemingly underneath his skin. He all in his feelings, so he can't control those outbursts, those ticks. He got to do something. Let me spit on him. Let me say I'm gonna slap him. Let me say I want to put him in a coma. And speaking of putting him in a coma, let me read the quote from one Pauly Malignaggi when he said about putting this guy in a coma after their June 22nd fight. Look, he said, at day's end, the reason for me to say put him in a coma or kill him or whatever, listen, you don't want to ever wish bad things on anybody, but honestly, would I feel bad if he wound up there? No, I wouldn't feel bad because he disrespected all of the families and all of the people that I've known personally who have gone through this. So, he's saying that the reason for his ignorant outbursts is because our team Lowball have disrespected people he personally know. And I know you got personal friends, relatives that have been through, you know, unfortunate situations, and for somebody to talk about it in a disrespectful way is hurtful, and it infuriates you, makes you want to get revenge or put hands on them, put foot to ass, however you want to go handle your business. But it is still ignorant. You still have millions of people watching you. You still have a reputation to uphold. And I understand. He's a fighter. He has to get mentally in sync to go through a brutal training camp to prepare for a combat sport that is brutal. These guys will not be fighting with 8-ounce gloves, 10-ounce gloves, or 3-ounce gloves. These guys are bare knuckle with the bare minimum protection and layers over their knuckles. They just going to have hand wraps, and that's it. The best man will win. But Paulie Malignaggi, he's saying this because he know. Look, yes, boxers, MMA fighters can do serious damage with their hands, with their feet, even covered in gloves. But to only strip us down of just, you know, hand wraps, I'm really about to murk this motherfucker. Ain't no way around it. I'm going to murk this motherfucker, and I'm going to put him in an ever irreversible situation with these hands. And that is what Paulie Malignaggi is pretty much saying. And for him to say he don't feel bad, he won't feel bad, is a head scratcher. For one, you talking about putting him in a coma, forever changing his life. Two, you spit on the man. You spit on the man. Paulie is highly emotional. He's in his feelings. This guy has ruffled his feathers, and now Paulie is ready to put hands on him. But Paulie better be aware that that shit is just extra motivation, extra fuel to the fire that Lobov is having burned and turned in his stomach. He like, this motherfucker really, he really, and spit on me, at me, in my direction. When we supposed to be professionals, it's one thing to say vulgar language and throw insults towards one another, but to cross the line like that, with his actions and his comments, I better hear everybody in their mama, in their grandma, in their pops, getting in Paulie's ass like they did Deontay Wilder. They better be highly offended. And this is not to make light of what Deontay Wilder said, but this is just to highlight that it has to be consistent. It can't be biased and unfair. If Wilder is getting crucified and highly criticized for saying these heinous things and, you know, putting that negative energy out there in the universe, then Paulie Malignaggi needs to get the same attention, the same crucification, the same criticism, and the same name drug and through the mud because he said these things. If everybody want to act like they're so holy and act like they're so above violence, which is laughable anyway because we watch MMA, we watch boxing, we watch football, high contact sports that does include high skill but also high collision, violent collisions. So let's keep it pushing with that almighty uprighteousness. You know what I'm saying? Because if you was that high and mighty, you wouldn't watch anything violent. But you do. So everybody that criticized Deontay Wilder for saying he's trying to catch a body with Dominique Brazil, that he want to be the last face that Brazil sees when he's in the hospital laying and looking up, they better do the same thing to Paulie Malignaggi for his comments directed towards our team, Lobov. Because if not, then y'all motherfuckers better not ever say shit else about what another fighter said. Simple as that. Simple as that. That is all I have for this video. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Make sure you drop those comments in the comment section down below, giving me your thoughts on this video. And if you enjoy the content throughout the channel, go ahead and smack that subscribe button and hit that notification bell button to be notified every time I upload content. Shout out to the movement and everybody that is moving with us. Be sure to check out 3kingsboxing.com for your latest and greatest updated, unfiltered, and unbiased boxing news and information reported the way it should be. Until next time, I am out. Peace.